Hello and welcome to Designer How. Today we're going to bring a still image to life by giving it a 3D look. Let's go. Open your image in Photoshop. The first thing we'll want to do is select the subject. I used the quick selection tool, but use whatever tool you want as long as you can isolate the subject. Once that's done, we'll go to select, then click modify and smooth. We'll set smooth to about 3 pixels. This will smoothen out any rough edges remaining around our subject. Click Ctrl plus J on your keyboard, and the selection will automatically be copied onto a new layer. Hold Ctrl and click the thumbnail for our new layer, and it'll bring back the selection. Now we'll click the background layer, then head to Select, Modify, and click Expand. We'll set Expand to about 15 pixels. Then we'll hit Shift plus F5 to bring up the Fill menu, make sure it's set to Content Aware, and click OK. As you can see, Photoshop has used its magic to fill in the gap our subject has left and does a pretty good job of it as well. It doesn't need to be perfect, just passable. I isolated the subject layer to key out some imperfections with the eraser tool. When you're happy with the results, go to File and be sure to save the project as a PSD file. We'll then fire up Premiere, navigate to the file location in the media browser, right-click it and choose Import. Make sure to import as individual layers. Open the folder, right-click the background layer, and select New Sequence from Clip, and it will appear on the timeline. Drag the subject layer onto the timeline as well, and make sure it sits above the background layer. We'd recommend letting the background zoom out and the subject zoom in. This will create a nice parallax effect that livens up the image. For the background layer, in Effect Controls, create a keyframe for scale on the first frame and put it at 110, scrub forth the timeline and set it back to 100. Now for the subject layer, we'll go in the opposite direction. Keyframe scale on the first frame at 100 and the last frame 110. And look at this beautiful animation. Marvelous. We can even liven it up some more by putting a texture image above the clips and, under opacity, setting its blend mode to screen. Bringing down the opacity will add a nice textured look to the image. It's as simple as that, a professional look achieved in only a few minutes. Hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Like and subscribe for more videos, and we will catch you all on the next one.